All right, so welcome everybody to Meaningful Monday here in the beginning of July. So for all those who've been here before on a Meaningful Monday, welcome back. Thank you so much for joining again. It's so lovely to see you all. And for anyone who's new, first time comers, very, very warm welcome to you. Just to quickly frame it up for the new people, Meaningful Monday is just a free webinar I do on the first Monday of every month. And the purpose is just really to raise awareness on different subjects. Every month's a different one, and it's just really about more and more awareness that we do create our own reality. And many years ago, I'm talking many years, like before 2006, I never thought that. I thought I responded to the reality that was being created. And as years have gone by, the more I've studied the material, and many of you know, many of you are silver graduates here, we do create our own reality. So just really, how do we live life with more grace and ease and get what we want? So tonight, I'm really excited to talk about this lovely topic, Put Your Dream to the Test. It's quite a compelling title. Certainly was for me the first time I saw John Maxwell's book. So it's a title to one of John Maxwell's book, Put Your Dream to the Test. So what I'm going to take you through tonight is top of the waves, I call it, from the book, Put Your Dream to the Test. This book has got 10 chapters in it, and each chapter, it looks like one question, but of course with John Maxwell, one question is never quite one question. You've got to answer several things to get that one question answered. There's many facets around everything, but we definitely can't get through all of it tonight. But what I do promise you is we'll get through two, and I'll show you all 10 like steps to really put your dream to the test and have it pass the test, basically, and then you can achieve that dream. And I think this is a really good subject because for me personally, this really struck a chord. There was a time in my life where I had a dream and I wasn't living the dream. And it was for quite a few years, just a few people coming on now, sorry. And I never lived into that dream, but it was burning inside me, and it went on for quite a while, and I just came to the point where I thought to myself, I'd rather die trying to live my dream than live with regret. And I think depending on the person and depending on the circumstances in you in your life, we all do come to a place at some stage, whether it's when we're young or 30 or 40 or even when we're much older, it doesn't matter what age. I'll just tell you this. To give anyone who thinks that it's too late or you're too old, I just want to say it's never too late and you're never too old. And one of my favorite authors is Louise Hay. I've read some of her books, and I absolutely admire her work tremendously. And Louise Hay basically found her life purpose at 61, and she was at the peak of her career in her 80s. And if you don't know who Louise Hay is, she's the founder and creator of Hay House, which is the biggest personal development publishing house in the world. And great authors like Deepak Chopra, Wayne Dyer, so many others have been published through Hay House. And if you think about 61, finding out what was really her calling or her purpose, and then she went after that, and that she was at the peak of her career in her 80s, I don't know, I just look at people I know in my life who are in their 80s, and it's a totally different picture. But that's why I talk about Louise Hay, because for anybody, no matter how old you are, it's never too late. And just to tell you, Louise Hay published her last book at 91, I think. She passed when she was 92. So here I am tonight to share this with you, and I am extremely excited to be speaking about this topic, because this topic, as I said, changed my life. I'm extremely passionate about it. I'll do anything I can to help anybody I know who has a dream achieve their dream. And those who know me and have known me for a long time, especially in the personal development phase when I left corporate in 2015, will know that that's really my business today, is to help people become more successful, become more wealthy, achieve what they want to do. It really is my passion. And so tonight, talking about pursuing dreams is really something I love to talk about. So I just want to tell you this. You may have seen it in the video. I sent a quick video out, I think, Friday. which was just about the Meaningful Monday tonight, and I'll just share it here again. When I lost my younger brother in 2012, he was only 21, his name was Gianmarco. In fact, yesterday was the anniversary of his passing, which was Independence Day, and it was for him truly independence because he suffered quite badly from epilepsy and was on heavy medication and was always hurting himself with a seizure. So when he passed, it truly was his Independence Day. Anyway, the point of telling you this is in 2012, when that happened in my life, it was the worst and the best thing at the same time. It was the worst thing because it was the saddest event of my life. But in retrospect, looking back, it kicked me into a stage of questioning my own life so deeply and wondering, what am I really doing with my life, and is it really what I really want? And asking myself hard questions that I never wanted to face before that. And I was happy in corporate. I had a really great corporate career. I even changed industries. I started off, believe it or not, out of hotel school in catering. I then went into supermarket retailing. I then went to the supply side of that. And then I ended up in market research, selling information to the big retailers or working with their data. And through those years, I really had a good time, but there was always this underlying feeling that there's got to be more to life than this. And if that's ever something that you can relate to, then this Meaningful Monday is really for you. When I had that feeling, there's got to be more to life than this, it was that I had what I call unfulfilling success. I had success according to certain measures that some people rate, whatever it is. We ask 100 people, what is the definition of success? I promise you'll get 100 different answers. But for me, you know, it wasn't about material acquisition anymore. You know, it wasn't about that. It was just, I really wanted my life to count and I wanted my life to matter. So when my brother passed on and I spent so much time reflecting, somehow, some way, I was led intuitively to join the John Maxwell team. And I can tell you now that I never read this book back then, and I think to myself today, if I had read it back then in 2012, how different would my journey have been? I don't know the answer, and I'll probably never know the answer. But at the worst time of my life, which was just 2 years before he passed in 2010 or so, when I just moved to Australia and I was in this new role, I actually found the silver method then, and that helped me turn things around. And once he passed and I joined the John Maxwell team, there's a day in my life that I'll never forget. What happened was I joined the John Maxwell team and they just start to train you. Every single night I was on a teaching call just like this. I was either in a mastermind or on a teaching call or with a mentor, on a mentorship call or studying or something nonstop. And then the one day I just shared it with some people at work as a free, just a free training session, a free 45-minute leadership training. I went back to my desk and the girl who sits next to me, Karen, asked me, how did you enjoy giving that free leadership talk? And it was just, you know, for the love of it. And I said, oh, Karen, I loved it. I loved it with a passion. And when I said that word passion, I connected it to something my mentor told me, which was, in your passion lies your God-given purpose. And it was that day that I thought, is it possible that my purpose could be teaching or training, especially something like leadership? At the time, this was all I was studying. But that made me realize that if I could do that, that would honestly and truly be my dream. And I loved the silver method so much because it helped me turn my life around a few years before. And I was still using it every day, just, you know, for better health, better results, achieving goals, whatever it was. And that was another thing. Anyone I met, I would share that with them. The silver method, use my program, take my CDs, listen to the audios, do the program, you know. And at some point I wrote to Silver International and I said, it would be my dream to teach this to others. And I can't find a trainer in Australia. You know, is there any way that I could apply to become the Silver Method trainer in Australia? And today I am the only trainer in Australia and have been since 2016. And that, amongst other things, really, really for me was a dream come true. And every time I train the Silver Method, and those of you who've been in my course, you will know, I love that program with a passion. I've seen it change lives, people that I know and even people that I haven't met but know their stories. It's phenomenal. So that really was achieving a dream. And I have to tell you, going from corporate after 20 years and stepping into that life is not just easy and it didn't happen like this and it wasn't simple. And at some point I was terrified, and I mean terrified, and you might look at me today and say, Arjuna, you would never be terrified. Yes, I was. I was really scared. I was full of doubt. I had no idea how I'd ever cross that bridge and get out of corporate. I was terrified to get away from the security of a paycheck. And I look back now, I see it completely differently. And all I can say is, if I can help people from my viewpoint, I will. Because this is the one thing I heard that made me sit up and decide that I would rather die trying to live my dream than live with regret. I was on a teaching call with one of my mentors, and he was sitting there in Michigan in the USA with a big coat outside. There was snow everywhere, and he had a big bonfire behind him, at like a fire pit in his back garden of his house, beautiful home. And he sat there and he was rubbing his hands and with a cup of coffee, and he said, I'm doing this quick teaching call. And he said, you know what I love about my life, he said, is freedom. He said, I do what I want, when I want, how I want, with who I want. And it was that day that I thought, wow, imagine that. And, you know, besides the passion and what I wanted to do teaching, it was really that freedom that was part of my dream. And I'm here tonight to tell you that it is possible. If you are committed to your dream, it's possible for anyone to achieve the dream they want. And when I say if they committed, because the truth is, it's not an easy road and it's full of obstacles along the way. And they're going to be things that challenge you. And you do need to have enough passion to be persistent and to stay the road. So this is the most phenomenal book. When it's put your dreams to the test, it's like a test. And you answer these questions and you actually see if your dream will pass the test. And if it doesn't, you know how to change it. And if it doesn't, you know what questions you ask and you know what clarity to find for yourself. So I'm going to take you through 2 of the 10 chapters in this book tonight. And if you want to know more, there's an opportunity to dive deep into this, because I will be running a mastermind later on in the year on this book. And if you want to join, I'll tell you about that at the end. Is that okay with everyone? So you're keen to get started? If you do have a chat box, you can type in the chat box and put a Y for yes or question there if you want at any stage. Otherwise, unmute your own microphone at any stage and just speak. You don't have to wait for the opportunity to have me say speak. You can just do it. Sounds great. Thank you, Serena. Thanks, Serena. Thanks for joining. And thank you, Sandra. Lovely. All right. So let's begin. So this is John Maxwell's little quote here. It says, a dream is an inspiring picture of the future that energizes your mind, will, and emotions, empowering you to do everything you can to achieve it. I really like this word inspiring, because I always use this example. If somebody called you, if I called you at 2 o'clock in the morning and you happened to answer your phone, what would I have to say to you that would have you get out of bed and get dressed and get over and meet me to discuss something that you really, really, really want? What would it be? That's a really way to say, well, if you did that and got up at 2 a.m. and did that, that thing inspires you. And you do need to have a dream that inspires you, because if we don't have the dream that inspires us, we aren't enthusiastic enough and we won't, you know, stick to the dream and the road and the journey through obstacles if we don't have something inspiring enough. So it is an inspiring picture of a future that you can see. And if you can't see it clearly, I'm telling you, this is one of the most important steps, is to get clarity on what it is that you really want. And it says, energizes your mind. Okay, that we get. Your will. Your will is everything. Your will is one of the faculties of your mind. You've got 6 faculties of the mind. You've got memory, intuition, imagination, willpower, perception, and reason. And will is a really amazing gift, because we can apply ourselves with this faculty of the will to achieve anything we really want if we will. Interesting word. And of course our emotions, and that comes down to passion. So I do love that quote. And I'm going to ask you now just to take, I don't know, I'll give you a few seconds, maybe a minute. Just ask yourself, the question, I'm asking you, what is your dream? And will you achieve it in your lifetime? So don't worry too much about the second question just yet, but if you have a dream, just either raise your hand or put Y in the chat box. Do you have a dream that you want to realize and that's either old, you've suppressed it, you've settled for not living it, you've buried it, or it's a new dream, or it's an inspiring dream? Do you have a dream? Just put answer in the chat box a Y if you have a dream, any dream. I'm not going to ask you to tell the people. Okay, Claire said yay. But this is important, just to be honest with yourself. I'm not asking you to tell anyone here, but just be honest with yourself. Do you have a dream that you haven't wanted to say or admit? Okay, thank you. Some people said, I think so. That's honest. Some people said yes. So it's a really important starting point to ask this question. You know, what is your dream? Because if you're able to answer that question, you're already like somewhat on a better footing or a better place to kind of realize it. Now, before we go on, I just want to also ask, maybe you have a situation in your life right now where you're unfulfilled. That could be a precursor to you saying, well, that was me. I was unfulfilled, but I didn't know what I wanted. So if that's you, then maybe put a U in the chat box. You're unfulfilled. You've got this feeling there's got to be more to life than this, but you don't know what it is that you wanted. When I was unhappy, when I say unfulfilled, I was in corporate and I had success, but I had feelings got to be more to life than this. I was unfulfilled. I didn't know what it is that I wanted, but I knew that this that I was living couldn't possibly be the best of my life. It couldn't be the best thing ever. Okay, that's me definitely. That's me too. Some more people said, I think so, but need to think about it more to make sure it's really my dream. I like the way you wrote that, Margot, my dream in capital letters, because step number one of this book is actually to know if it's your dream or not your dream. Is it someone else's dream, perhaps? Someone says, I think so too. I think so. So it is important to think, you know, am I unfulfilled right now? Did I have a dream years ago, even when I was much younger, even when you were a teenager or a kid, I don't know, or in your early 20s, if you're older than that today, and you did have it as a dream, but you thought, oh, I can't really achieve it. There's a second question. Will I achieve it? I don't really think I can, or I don't know how, or maybe it's not possible for me, or I don't have the confidence, whatever it is, and you thought, I'm going to just give it up. So if that's any of you, I hope I want to decide on my next dream. Great. I love that. Then think about that, and you know, we're going to definitely cover that. So an unidentified dream, if you don't have a dream but you know that it's not what you're living right now, so it's unidentified. So let's talk about that. So as I said, a dream is an inspiring picture of the future that energizes your mind, will, and emotions. So just keep that in mind as you think about it. All right, so here we go. These are five common reasons for not identifying our dreams. The first one is discouragement from dreaming by other people. So I don't know if you know the term dream killers, dream crushers, idea killers. It's people who actually don't have dreams of their own and they actually don't want to see anyone else succeed with their dreams either. That's people who discourage you. The second reason people don't identify their dreams is past disappointments or past hurts. And if you want to know what disappointment's definition is, it's a gap between your expectation and your reality. And if you've had a big disappointment in your life between something you really expected and the reality was quite different, that could actually dampen you or be a hindrance to having a new dream. And in saying that, I must add, when it comes to disappointments, if you're making notes, you want to write this one down. Failure is the price we must pay for success. When I was younger, I thought you could achieve dreams and achieve success and just miss the failures along the way. Like, you know, just be smart about it or be clever about it. Or, I don't know, strategic, and you could avoid failures. Now, as I'm more mature and have walked the path myself and have understood things, I understand today that it's not that at all. Failure is such a bad word. We should actually eliminate failure from the dictionary. It's not about failure. It's about trial and error. It's about trying things and learning from them. And they don't work and we try something else and we learn from them. But to say failure, in my view, failure is when you give up, is when you stop trying. And we, if you want to dream, I have to just tell you, if you really want it, you'll never give up. And one of the masterminds I run more than any other one, as you may know, is Think and Grow Rich. And the chapter on persistence is a challenge that everyone must read that chapter every day for 14 days in a row without missing a day. If you miss a day, you've got to go back to zero and start again until you've done your 14-day challenge. And why on the chapter of persistence? Because it's exactly that kind of challenge. If you don't do it, you've got to get back on again and go again, and you have to persist. And you have to, and once you read that whole chapter, it takes about 40 minutes to read, you actually get all the points about the importance of persistence. And I'll just say, failure is the price we must pay for success. And there will be mistakes and there will be some things that go wrong, but we do need to persist. And it was John Maxwell who actually was the person or the mentor in my life, even though it's through books. You know, once I joined the John Maxwell team, I was blessed enough to be in front of him in the audience every year from 2012 until now, except for the COVID year and 2021 so far. But I remember him saying that if you want to avoid making mistakes, you aren't going to learn a lot in life. And you need to be open to mistakes. And I just want to say that here as well. Some reason that people don't want to identify their dreams is they're afraid of failure and they're afraid of making mistakes. And they think, what if it doesn't work? Well, so what if it doesn't work? You try something else. There's not one way to do anything. There's many ways to do something. And once I changed that, I actually made a New Year's resolution. I remember one year and I said, my New Year's resolution is embracing making mistakes. Because for me, that was a really foreign concept. I didn't like to try things that I'd potentially fail in. And I'm so glad I changed that and pushed myself to just do more with the openness to failing or succeeding. Because the truth is, when you make mistakes and when you fail, there's a lot more you learn than when you're always successful in something. We don't really learn much from success. We learn way more from our failures. So that's the second one. The third one is the habit of settling for average. I'm going to tell you, this one scares me the most. It's my personality. I just do not like the word settle on any level, in any area of a person's life. Don't settle for bad health. Don't settle for bad wealth. Don't settle for bad relationships. You know, never settle. You are worth way, way, way more than that. And you are deserving and worthy of being really, really happy in this life and fulfilled. And you need to do whatever it takes to create the life of your own design. Do not settle. If things are not right, just never settle. So people who settle for average potentially don't want to go out of their comfort zone and they don't want to stretch, because dreams require a person to stretch. They require you to go beyond average. And really, I have to say, you cannot reach a dream and remain safely mediocre at the same time. They are completely incompatible. To just have an average life and want to have a dream, you think you can do both, you can't. You can't just cruise and achieve a dream. No one has ever said, if you know anyone who's highly successful and achieved some big goal, I've never heard someone say, oh, honestly, I don't know how I did that. I don't know how I just like landed up here with this great achievement. I don't know, just woke up one day and I was so successful. I've never heard that from anyone. They will tell you about their struggles. They'll tell you about their failures, their stories of how they persisted. And truly, you do need to stretch. I remember how many things I had to do to get out of my comfort zone to make that transition from corporate into doing what I'm doing today. And it was a stretch. From the day I wrote my vision statement as to what I really wanted to the day that I actually stepped out of corporate, it was approximately a year and 1 month. Let's call it 13 months or so. And that might seem like a long time for some of you, and that might seem like not a long time for some of you. for me, it was a long time. Probably I'm quite an impatient person, and I couldn't understand after a year how come what I wanted to have achieved by then and I hadn't. And I wanted this golden bridge, I call it, to, you know, get out to financially sustain me while I built a personal development and training business. And I spent money investing in a property renovation course, cost me $5,000, the Sherry Barber course. I spent so many weekends and hours looking at property to renovate. I was going through the drill of all the work, and it was a lot of homework. But, you know, I was so immersed in this, you know, pushing forward for this that I wanted, that eventually, after about 11 months or so, I looked back and I thought, why is this still not happening for me? And then I just remembered a 30-day principle. Some of you have heard me talk about this, where Jack Canfield explained that they took NASA astronauts and gave them goggles that made the image back to front and upside down, and made them wear them 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, to test what would happen if they were disorientated in space. And they wanted to see, would they be hostile, would they be sick, would they be nauseous? But what they never expected was between day 25 and 30, the brain corrected the image. It was no longer upside down and back to front. I thought, wow, we never expected that. They did the experiment again, and they made two groups. The one did the same thing 24/7, and the other group, they made them take their goggles off for just one day, on day 15. And did you know it took that second group 25 to 30 additional days from day 15 before the brain corrected the image? So what they proved there is it takes more than 30 days to really create a new neural pathway. So what I did on that day is I took my vision board. I had a vision board. I was using the silver method as well then. And I made sure I logged the days. I actually wrote them down in an app on my phone. And I did a certain visualization and looked at my vision board every day for 30 days. And it went eventually to past day 36. It didn't happen first time. I missed it on like day 18 and just start again from zero. I did it again. Got to some day like around 23. I missed it again. I thought, oh no, started again. But when I crossed day 30, I was going past that. Literally 4 weeks later, the opportunity came with Mike, who's 2020 Property Advisory's owner, to sell investment property. And all I'm saying to you is, when you really want something and you're not prepared to settle for what you want, you will get it. But you do need to stay the road. Never give up. Never settle. And don't think that you can cruise your way there. So, you know, the habit for settling, that needs to be eliminated from your life. I don't know if it is you or it isn't you. I'm just saying that is incompatible with a dream. Just trying to get this off the space here. Okay, the next one is lack of confidence needed to pursue dreams. It does take confidence. Just to talk about a dream takes confidence, let alone going after it. To be able to articulate something to someone about what you want takes confidence, and it takes even more confidence to want to pursue a dream. And you know, I have to say that it's confidence often that separates the people who dream from the people dream and pursue their dreams from those who don't. So confidence is a really big deal. And the good thing about self-confidence is you can change your self-confidence. And if you've got children, please be aware that if you think your children by any way, shape or form could be more confident and you wish they were, please know that's not how it's the end of, you know, it's the end and they just aren't like that. No, self-confidence can be changed. If you're a Silver Method graduate, you can use Mirror of the Mind. It is highly, highly effective. I know because I've done it myself through things that I wasn't confident in. I just use the technique. It's visualizing. Just visualize yourself in the thing you don't feel confident in, doing that thing with confidence regularly, like every day, every second day. I can promise you, if the best example is public speaking. If you know anyone who doesn't have confidence in that area, just, especially if it's your child, take the time to sit with them and make them visualize, even for just 5 minutes, at least 3 to 5 times before they deliver that whatever, speech, talk, whatever it is. And I promise you they'll walk away that day saying it was the best one they had ever done. And they felt more confident than they've ever felt. You can change your self-confidence and you can change it strongly. So that one doesn't have to remain an inhibitor or a reason for not identifying what your dream is. If you don't think you can do it, you can change that confident feeling in yourself to say, yes, this is something I want to do, and yes, I can do it, and I will do it, and go after it. The last one is lack of imagination. Some people do lack imagination to dream. And imagination is important. Even Napoleon Hill says what the mind can conceive and believe it can achieve. What the mind can conceive. If you want to be more healthy, you need to imagine yourself more healthy first. Otherwise, you won't. If you want to be more wealthy, you have to imagine yourself more wealthy, or you actually can't create it. I know it sounds like a harsh word, but it's the truth. We have to imagine that future and do it so repeatedly and so often that it actually becomes familiar. The term I use is you have to actually create a memory of the future you. Keep seeing that image in your mind with imagination. And it doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter what conditions you're in. If you can imagine that better future you, you can create it. There is so much untapped potential in all of you. You know, and you've heard this before, Abraham Maslow said it decades ago, your potential is unlimited. So if you know your potential is unlimited, so is your imagination. And that's why your potential is unlimited. Because if you can imagine it strongly enough, and I mean this when I say initially, you don't need to know how. It even says it in John Maxwell's book. You don't answer the how question and work out a strategy. It's not the way you create your dream. The first thing you've got to know is what it is that you want. And this is why you need to be able to imagine it and articulate it for yourself. Okay. So in the book, as I said, there are 10 steps. We're going to go through two of the 10 tonight. We're going to go through ownership and we're going to go through cost. But have a look at them all. You've got to own your dream. Know that it's yours. You've got to have proper clarity. Chapter 2 is quite a fantastic chapter. It does challenge a person. It challenges you solidly. But boy, when you do the homework on chapter 2, it changes everything. And everything is much easier from that point on. So I think chapter 2 for me, I thought was the most difficult chapter of all. And then reality. You've got to face reality. Passion, hugely important to get there. You've got to know your pathway. So pathways way later, as you can see. Step 5. We don't ask about pathway on step 2. We just want to know what it is. Don't ask how, just what is it? What is it that you want? And do you have enough passion for that thing? Does it excite you? Does it keep you up at night? Is it something you really, really love to do? Then, of course, there's an element with people, the people around you. No one's achieved a great dream on their own. And you actually do need people, whether they're people who are in a team to help you get there, or a mentor or a coach in your life, or a group of people like a mastermind. There's some masterminds that have gone on for 4 years, 5 years of the same group of people. My mentor was one of them. And that's how he and that group of people became all multimillionaires. They started at about 24, 5 years of age. They formed a mastermind on Think and Grow Rich, and they got together weekly for 4 years. By the time they were 30, every one of them was a multimillionaire. And it honestly was the power of the mastermind. It's a chapter in Think and Grow Rich with the power of the mastermind. So it really is, the mastermind is a way to just share with people and have different perspectives and how people help you and support you, and things that bother you, you put them on the table. People really rally to help you, and you do the same for them. And it's a very, very powerful process because you feel supported. You feel like you're also part of a like-minded group. I mean, that's so important. The worst thing about having a dream is all these people around who don't go after dreams themselves, maybe, and they certainly may not believe that you and your dream is a possibility, because I'll tell you why. If there's someone in your life that's a dream killer, it's not that they want to harm you in any way. It's because they can't see themselves achieving that dream. That's your dream. And if they can't see it, well, they can't tell you that they can see you do it, unless, of course, they have a high level of awareness and they love you dearly and they believe in you enormously. But generally speaking, when someone says something that they themselves don't know how to do, they don't know how you're going to do it either. Then there's the cost question. There's a cost, there's a price to pay. There's no doubt there's a price. And the question is, are you willing to pay the price? And then there's tenacity, that's sticking to it the whole way through. Fulfillment is really important, that this dream does tick the box of fulfillment for you. And last but not least is significance. That means, how does it relate to others? John Maxwell says, success is all about me. Significance is all about others. And once you've tasted significance, success will never satisfy you again. And I have to tell you, it's true. And you will know that in your own life. When you really help another person and add value to them, and you make a difference, and it's something meaningful, it's the best day you've had. So significance is such an important element to consider when you're planning your dream. Why would you plan a dream that at the end of this whole thing, it's not fulfilling enough and you don't get that feeling of significance? That's what the human being yearns for. It's significance. It's not success. Because if you have success, you'll just want something else that'll give you that success. Once you've got that, you'll look for something else. But when you have significance, that's different. Your life is fulfilling and you are content with a full feeling of meaning in your life. And that's a very different thing. All right. I love this quote. It says, God has put a dream inside you. It's yours and no one else's. It declares your uniqueness. It holds your potential. Only you can birth it. Only you can live it. Not to discover it, take responsibility for it, and act upon it is to negatively affect yourself as well as all those who would benefit from your dream. And that's so true. When you live your dream, you benefit others around you. You don't know how much, I promise you, you really do. You become a light to the world. And it doesn't matter what that thing is. So it says here, a dream becomes a reality as a result of your actions, and your actions are controlled to a large extent by your habits. So habits is a big part of the book. It goes through a whole section on habits in the book where you need to identify your bad habits. You've got to know what they are, how they hold you back. You've got to identify your good habits and how they've helped you achieve success through your whole life. There are certain things that each one of us have that do, that are good habits. And then he asks you about new habits. What new habits do we need to develop to achieve our dream? So really important, this quote. And as many of you know, habits are in your subconscious programming below your level of awareness, sub below conscious awareness. In your subconscious mind are your habits and your beliefs. So 95% of everything you do is habitual. It's a program that you learned long ago and it now just runs. And these are our habits. And some of them are really good and they serve us, and some of them really don't serve us. And we do need to take a look at our habits because they do control our actions. Okay, so the first thing is ownership. So this is about, is it your dream? Are you living your dream or the dream someone else has for you? Have you ever heard people say, you know, you should be a, I don't know, whatever it may be, a doctor or an accountant? Or have you ever thought, I always wanted to be a, let's say, a vet, but my parents wanted me to be a lawyer? Have you ever heard that? Maybe that's you even. And then the person went on to do that thing not to disappoint their parents. So that wasn't their dream. If you know anybody like that, or if it is you, you will know that you'll never really ever be happy, and that is not the way to live. So this is chapter one. Why does John Maxwell make it chapter one? Well, it's the most important place to start. You need to know that the dream is yours. And a very good question that he asks is, you know, if you did achieve your dream, who in the world would be the happiest person alive because you achieved your dream? Is it you, or is it your mother, or is it your partner, or whoever it may be? So, you know, sometimes people have this dream and it's so different to their own lives. There's some amazing stories in this book that will inspire you, where these were these parents in a certain kind of pattern for generations, and then the child comes along completely different to the parents and has a completely different passion. And whether they go for it or they don't go for it, these stories that unfold. But at the end of the day, it's got to be your own dream. You need to own that dream. So taking ownership of your dream, I'll go through these, not necessarily in the exact order that they're on the slide. I'll just go through them. The first one is asking and answering the question, how do you take ownership of your dream? Well, the first thing, you've got to be willing to bet on yourself. You may succeed even if nobody believes in you. You can have the whole world not believe in you, but if you believe in you, you may still succeed. But I'll tell you this, if you don't believe in yourself, you will never succeed, no matter who believes in you. So you do need to bet on yourself. That's why I go back to the thing about self-confidence. You can work on your self-confidence, and we all should be working on our self-confidence. Really important thing. So the next one is lead your life instead of accepting your life. So successful people, those who see their dreams and seize their dreams, they love what they do. They do what they love. They follow their passion. They follow their talents and gifts. They look at what they're good at. Why? Because your talent, your purpose, and your potential always come hand in hand when you're going after a dream. So even for myself, the day that I gave that free talk on leadership and I said, oh, I loved it with a passion. What I realized was I really love teaching. I really love public speaking. And these are areas of my giftedness. Communication is an area of my giftedness. So why would I not go into an area of a dream if I think about it? Even if you're scared, you don't know how to get there, but it uses your giftedness, that's right. And if there's something that doesn't use your giftedness, and we all have talents and gifts, everybody, every single person does. No one can tell me, I don't have any. There's no such thing. You all have some unique talents and gifts. And if it uses your giftedness and it's something you love to do, you're getting close. You're in the right zone now. You know, you're really getting close to what this thing that's right for you is. So when it says lead your life instead of accepting your life, I just want to tell you that the power of choice is the greatest power that a human being possesses. And you have choice. And you need to make your own choices. Your own. Even if it's something that you want to do and you have a different way of doing that to somebody else, you need to make your own choices. And you do have that freedom of choice. And it's really something highly, highly valuable. The next one is to love what you do and to do what you love. That's so true. Very important. And then the next one, don't compare yourself. Comparison is the thief of joy. If you compare yourself to someone superior to you, whatever that looks like, you're going to feel inferior. If you start comparing yourself to people who you think are inferior to you, you're going to feel superior. But when you stop comparing, you feel empowered. Focus on yourself. The only thing you need to compare yourself with is yourself and who you were yesterday. And are you becoming a better version of yourself? And all I can say is when I was in that transition of trying to work out how to go from corporate to stepping into my dream, I got these words from one of my personal development teachers through books and audio programs, which is Mike Dooley. And he says, do what you can with what you got from where you are. And when there were times when I was full of doubt, I just said that, do what you can with what you got from where you are. And I do anything, register the ABN, do what you can. I still incorporate. What else can I do? Well, I can develop a 45-minute keynote on the subject I love most. Which leadership topic would it be? How would I talk about it? Frame it up, do a PowerPoint, whatever it is, practice, find people, add value, do it for free. I did so many masterminds for free when I was working in corporate, all on leadership. And this is the interesting thing. When I started off tonight, I forgot to share the story I wanted to share. When I did a free mastermind, still working my corporate job back at Nielsen, I finished the 21 laws of leadership with this group. And they said, oh, we want to do another mastermind. We've loved it so much. I said, okay, great. Well, look at John Maxwell's books. Which one would you like to do next? And 2 to 3 people came up with the same book, which was Put Your Dream to the Test. And at the time, I never felt qualified to lead that mastermind because I knew I had a dream and I hadn't fulfilled it. I was still there in corporate. So all I can say is, do what you can with what you got from where you are, step by step. You will eventually step into your dream. And when you do, you really become a light to people in your realm, in your sphere. When you succeed, you help others. You always do, even if it's that you inspire people to just own their own dream and do what you really want to do. The next one is believe in your vision. Even if people don't understand you or they don't agree with you or they think that you're crazy, you have a dream inside you. Everybody does. John Maxwell says that. He said, every person born on earth, God puts a dream inside your heart. Just recently on our radio show, Claire is here tonight on this Meaningful Monday. We have a radio show called the Meaningful Monday Show on a Monday. And Claire and I did The Alchemist just recently on a show. And, you know, it talks about, you know, finding your personal treasure. And the way to do it is to follow your heart. And it's very important that we actually have a heart. And the term, follow your heart, what does it mean? There is something that we love to do that really is a feeling like your heart's longing. That's another thing for you to maybe trigger if you don't know what your dream is. What do you really, really love to do? And if you do follow your heart, you will come across your purpose in life, your passion in life. You will find the thing that you're genuinely gifted in, because we all have to do what we do well. No one likes to do what you do badly. So, you know, your heart space is really important there. And I have to say, you are not an accident. You are born for a reason, and you have a lot of value to offer the world. And if you're not doing what you really love to do, I urge you, take the time to sit and reflect and think, what do you really want to do? And if you're not sure, that's also okay. Just keep asking, what do you love? What do you like? And experiment. You've got to step out of your comfort zone and try a whole lot of things. Okay, I just want to read this quote that I put down here. It says, if success is not on your own terms, if it looks good to the world but doesn't feel good in your soul, it is not success at all. The potential that exists within us is limitless and largely untapped. When you think of limits, you create them. So there we have it. You have unlimited potential. The potential that exists within us is limitless and largely untapped. When you think of limits, you create them. That's why even in this book of Put Your Dream to the Test, it says don't ask how, just say what it is that you want. We start thinking, I can't do it. How will I do it? I'm never going to do it. The reasoning mind comes in. And the way the brain works, your reasoning mind will tell you, if you haven't done this thing before in your past, that you cannot do it. This is how the brain is. The ego mind, the subconscious mind, is there to protect you, to avoid risk at all cost and keep you the same. Even if you're unhappy, that's what the comfort zone is. That's why getting out of your comfort zone feels so uncomfortable, because the whole subconscious mind and the ego mind wants to keep you the same, even if you're unhappy, as I said. So we do need to remember our potential is unlimited. We have a very, very powerful mind that can create absolutely anything. Before you go to how you'll do anything, just know what it is that you want. Okay. And if you had no limitations, well, when you take ownership of your dream, you commit to your dream. So you need to ask yourself, what is your level of commitment? If you had to say from 1 to 10, what is your level of commitment? Maybe 1 was, that would be nice to have. And maybe 10 out of 10 would be, you know, I lose sleep at night. I want this thing so badly. If you're an 8 or above out of 10, how much you really want your dream, I'm telling you, you are ready. You are ready to go for it, and you will get it. You'll be able to go through this, put your dream to the test and pass the test if you're an 8 out of 10. If you're less than that, you still have hope. You need to uncover what it is that makes your score low. Which of those areas, you saw those 10 steps, what is it? Is it your dream? Do you own the dream? Is it someone else's? Is there enough passion? Is it in line with your talents? Where is it? So those are very important questions. So ask yourself, what's your level of commitment? And this question next, I love. What if you knew you couldn't fail? What would you do? If you really knew that you would not fail, what would you do? So sometimes people avoid answering this question. They rather avoid it, because once you answer it, there's a level of responsibility there that you know, you actually have got something that you want to do that you haven't done. And even though you're afraid, because that's what it is, it's fear that holds us back. Can we take that step and go forward and actually do that thing? Okay. So the first step is being able to answer, you know, taking ownership and then prepare to start moving forward. So here comes the next section, the cost. The dream is free, but the journey will cost you something. There's a price to pay for every dream. But I'll just say this. It's worth it. It's absolutely worth it. If you thought how happy and fulfilled you'd be if you had this dream, this thing that you really want, the price is worth it. I'll just speak for myself. When I first realized that my true dream life, I didn't know at all, you got to understand, I came from 20 years of corporate, and I had no experience in the personal development space or as a coach or as a trainer or a speaker. So I just did this thing the one day, and it filled me with so much passion, and I loved it so much. It was really like, geez, it would be a dream come true. Imagine doing a life like this or doing this every day. Now, when that happened, it was only a few seconds or minutes later that all the limiting beliefs slowly but surely flooded in. You can't do this. How are you going to earn a living? What if you don't succeed? You're going to go backwards in life. What if you can't pay your bills? You got investment properties. How are you going to pay their mortgages? Whatever it may be, all these limiting beliefs, anything would pop in my head to stop me moving forward towards my dream. And this cost question is a very important question. And for me, these were my words. I said, I would rather die trying to reach my dream than to live with regret. I just, when my younger brother passed on, it was really such a wake-up call. I thought to myself, you know, he was here today, he's 21, he was gone the next. If I die tomorrow, is this my best life? And the answer truly was no, it wasn't my best life. So honesty with yourself is really important when thinking about your dream as well. Are you honest with yourself? Do you ask yourself the hard questions? But I thought, you know, what if I did live a long life? Let's just say I was blessed enough to live, and I'm, I don't know, whatever age, 95, on my deathbed, and I never went after my dream out of fear. I would have thought, why didn't I give it a go in my 40s? Why didn't I give it a go when I was 45? Why didn't I give it a go when I was 50? I still had enough energy, had enough time. Why didn't I do it when I was 60? I was so tired of that. Why didn't I go then? Then I was 70. Geez, I've given up the best years of all the energy now. And to think that I would have never have done it, that for me was my biggest fear. So we all have different biggest fears. Some people fear other things. But for me, my greatest fear was dying with regret. So when I made the decision, I will rather die trying. I just accepted if I was going to fail, I would just get up and try again and just get up and try again. But it's all I wanted to do. And I'll tell you something. When you know what you want to do and it really is your dream and you do own it and you're prepared to pay the price, success comes up behind you faster than you'll ever begin to imagine. When you really are on the right path of the thing that's truly right for you, and you are living your purpose with a passion and with faith in yourself, doors open, things start working out for you, and you will do better and be happier and more fulfilled than you've ever done being in something that pays the bills that doesn't really fill your heart. So, you know, you have one life. Live your best life. Find a way. Find everything you need, all the tools, all the mentors, all the coaches, whatever it is, to get you to live your dream. So when it comes to the cost question, the dream is free, but the journey isn't. So we're not just talking about the cost of dollars and cents. What are you willing to pay? What's the real price you pay? You're going to take time. It's going to take effort. You're going to have to learn more skills. For me, when I joined the John Maxwell team, I was still working in corporate. So just understand this. I joined the John Maxwell team in 2012. I left corporate in 2015. I realized what I wanted in 2014. So in 2012, I started to develop myself not knowing this would be my ultimate destination and future, I was just wanting to become a better leader in my corporate job, but it eventually unfolded into other things. But all I can say was when I was working on myself, this cost, like, it's not dollars and cents. Yes, it was an investment in money. There was as well. There's no doubt. But it was time. I never watched TV. I still don't watch TV much. I really don't. If I watch, I don't know, 2 hours of TV a week, it's a lot. I'm always reading. I'm always studying. I'm always listening to a podcast. I'm always learning something new. I'm always preparing something. And that's the cost, whatever it is. It could be different for a different dream, depending on what that skill is. But you do need to put in the work. No one else. It's not something you can delegate or buy. You have to do it yourself. So do you avoid the question? Like, what is it that you really have to do? What do you want to do? Are you willing to pay the price? Would you avoid the cost? If you would, then you potentially would avoid the dream. So we do need to say, yes, I'll do it and I'll pay the price. So the dream is free, but the journey isn't. The price must be paid sooner than you think. The price will be higher than you expect. And the price must be paid more than once. So John Maxwell always says, sacrifice means you have to give up to go up. And I don't really know if sacrifice is the right word, because sacrifice for me meant like some form of suffering. But actually sacrifice, if you define it correctly, for me it's giving up something of a lesser value for the attainment of something of a higher value. So if I give up TV to learn something new that I really love and I'm interested in, that for me is not actually a sacrifice. It's a choice I'm willing to make, because it's got all the benefits stacked up for me and I love that thing that I'm doing. So we do have to give up to go up, but you'll find it easy to give up something of a lesser value if you're going after something that you really value more. And is it possible to pay too much for your dream? What do you think? Do you think it is? I'll tell you this. It is possible to pay too much for your dream if it comes to the price of your health. If your health suffers as a result of just striving for this dream that you want, or your family, you sacrifice your family, or maybe your relationships, and worst of all is you sacrifice your values or your own integrity. In that regard, I'll say yes, don't do it. You won't enjoy the dream. Even if you get it, don't go there. So make sure that it doesn't do any of those things. And then, as I said, the types of costs, yep, it can be time. That for me was the biggest one, time with family and friends, or just time for leisure time. Dealing with criticism from people who matter. When I first expressed to my parents that I want to leave corporate after 20 years, I had just been promoted to director, and they knew me from my childhood and obviously when I first started working in my 20s. And they knew that it was something that I really wanted to achieve. For years and years, I wanted to become director of some, I don't know, company, some multinational if I could. And I just got that. And they said, you've just got everything you want. Why would you leave? You're making such a big risk. You're doing so well. The company's looking after you. You know, you've got your future ahead. But, you know, you might come up with that same thing with people who really matter in your life. And I just had to believe in my own dream and a fight for my own dream, and just, you know, tell, like, the people who loved me the most were the ones who were the most concerned, telling me it's too much of a risk. And I just had to say, please don't say anything. If you're not going to say yes, go for it, I believe in you, don't say anything, because this is all I really want to do. And it was actually 6 weeks after being promoted to director, I resigned. It meant nothing to me. When I was 20, that meant everything to me. When I got there, it meant nothing to me. What I really wanted was a burning desire to fulfill a dream that I could see, and nothing would keep me back. And that's what it should be for everybody. So as you work through the steps of working out your dream and you get clarity on it, and you know it aligns with your skills, your talents, your passions, and you start to ask yourself all the questions that I think are going to hold you back. Spoke about habits, there are several other things, and you work through all of that, you will come to a point where you will say, you know what, I can do this. I don't know how, but I'm going to go for it. And you don't know the whole way, but you just know the next 100 meters. And as you take those, your mind and your experience will tell you how to do the next 100 meters. And so you go. And you eventually one day look back and you're there. You just got to keep on going and believe in yourself and be willing to pay the price. And the biggest price is hard work. It takes hard work to do where you, what you, to do what you need to do to get where you want to be. Okay, so what's your dream worth? Well, only you can figure out what's your dream worth. You must work that out. You must say to yourself, what is it worth to me? Are you prepared to die with regret of not ever giving it a go? Please don't say yes, say no. Don't die with regret. Do what you can. And you don't have to leave security straight away to go there if it's something different in your work. You can start on the side and work in that area in your spare time. That's why it does take a sacrifice of time. And how much are you willing to pay for your dream? And also, what are you not willing to pay? You need to answer that question. What are you not willing to pay? Some people are not prepared to make certain sacrifices, and they need to be honest with themselves and know what that is and see how much of an obstacle that will be. Some prices may be too high. It's true. Just know that the bigger the dream, the bigger the cost. Faith, very big deal. Faith is daring to put your dream to the test. It's better to try to do something and fail than to try to do nothing and succeed. Absolutely, that's how it was for me. Okay, so let's sum it up. So how long it takes you to achieve your dream, that depends on you. You can't even say you'll complete, let's say, this book or even do the mastermind on this book and know that by the end of the 10th week you've got it. No. How long it takes depends on you, and the amount of time will be affected by how self-aware you are, like all your good habits, your bad habits, the truth about yourself, what brings you down, what's your greatest characteristic about you that makes you successful. So how self-aware you are, how honest you are about your own strengths, and how honest you are about your own weaknesses. I sure had some. I had to overcome them. So it's being really that self-aware and being honest with yourself, and also your personal history, looking back on your life, seeing what got you further, what held you back, really reflecting. And then also how much time and energy you've already given up to this particular dream or subject in the past. How much time have you invested in it? How much do you know about it? That's another question. How much would you also put into the future? So don't forget, the bigger the dream, the higher the cost. And if you're unwilling to pay what it's likely to cost, you need to either change the dream or change what you're willing to pay. And it's possible. You can do that. And you can work it out. And you can still get there. So just in closing, these 5 points, it's one thing to have a dream. It's another to do the things to achieve it. Absolutely. The 10 powerful, straightforward questions and put your dream to the test will definitely increase the odds of your dream becoming a reality. All it takes is that you engage in the process. And as I said, how long it takes depends on you. Increase the odds of your dream becoming a reality. Are you willing to give up to go up? Number 3 is take ownership. It really must be your dream and 100% yours. What you really want for you. What does your dream cost? There's a lot that you can delve into there, think about, work that out. And then the most important question is number 5, I think, is your dream worth it? So I just say and always say, it's worth it. Right there, sitting where you are, just tell yourself, if you have a dream, just say, my dream is worth it. If you're making notes, write that down. My dream is worth it. Yes, it's going to be hard. Yes, it's going to be a cost and give up some things and sacrifice and work it out. But it's so worth it. How much better than to imagine living your dream? It's worth it. And to actually have that feeling, knowing that you are, like people use this cliche, You know, I'm living the dream. But truly, if I speak for myself, I really am. I don't want to sound arrogant. I'm not that way at all. I'm just trying to tell you from the honest truth of my heart, I really am living my dream today. There are several things that are my passions. I do several different things. But if I just talk about the silver method, it was really a burning dream I had to become a trainer. And every time I train it, I just say, I was born to do this. And I know I really was. And that just, even if I do it 4 or 5 times a year, it's the greatest 4 or 5 times a year. It's just, I love it so much. I can't tell you. I'm so happy and grateful to myself for walking that path, because it was a lot of work. The cost was enormous. The monetary cost was enormous to go into America, being trained and having to do the silver method multiple times, traveling to America because there was no training here, investing thousands and thousands of dollars. But then when I became a trainer, before I could actually do my first class, I'm not kidding you when I'm telling you I invested hundreds and hundreds of hours of learning and preparation, hundreds. I've done an MBA in my life. Becoming a silver trainer was harder work than that. That's the truth, hand on heart, it really was. But you know what? It was worth it. So for you in your life, if there's something that you want, don't give up on yourself. Believe in yourself, have confidence in yourself, and find a pathway for you to get there. But live your dream. One life, live your best life. Make the rest of your life the best of your life. And you know what? The journey to making your dream a reality is also amazing. As much as it is up and down sometimes and full of failures and hard times, it's amazing. Because the whole time you know, you're really working to something that truly makes your heart happy. And there's no more satisfying feeling than that. That's the best feeling. Staying in something where you're not changing yourself and you're not changing your circumstances and you're not happy every day. What is that? That's just existing. We really deserve, you all deserve to live your best life. Don't let your life go by and just have it, I just existed. No, live your best life. And you wouldn't be on this Meaningful Monday tonight if that wasn't you. You're obviously here because that is what you want to do. Okay, so just to share with you, if you like this, we just touched on two of the principles and just a very bit of them. But if this is something that you really have in your heart and you do have a dream, I am going to dig deep into this book with a group of people, a mastermind. I'll just tell you up front, it's not for everybody. It really isn't. But if you are committed to your dream, it is for you. And if you really want your dream, but you've got no cooking clue how to get there, or you're unsure about some elements and you just haven't had the wherewithal or the honesty with yourself to answer the hard questions, then this is also for you, because all the hard questions are in this book. I did find it quite challenging on some chapters, but if you just take the time and answer those questions, you come out the other end with this enormous relief of clarity, and like you feel like you're actually making progress and you're getting somewhere. So as I said, it's not for everybody, but if it is for you, the mastermind is later in the year. It starts in September. It's $4.99 per person, but there's an early bird price of $3.99 per person. The early bird ends on the 1st of August. The mastermind starts on the 14th of September, and you can join via Zoom. If you are in Sydney, I'll go into the office on that night and you can join there too. So that's if anyone would like to join that. Otherwise, there is only one online silver method course in this year, and it's now in July. So if you'd like to join, please do book in. If you're new, it's $1,500 per person. If you're graduates, you know that you don't pay, you only pay a C charge. If you're graduate and you introduce someone, you don't pay anything at all. And for anyone who does do the online class, you can attend completely free, no C charge, no nothing, zero, any live class for the next 12 months into the future. Why? Because I do want you to have the group experience in the room with a group of people working together, you know, sometimes one-on-one in case working and things like that. So you do get that opportunity. So you lose nothing. You will come to a free training completely free anytime in the future. But it is nice in July to be at home in the comfort of your own home, have a blanket over your lap or whatever, and be able to spend the weekend doing the silver method. It's awesome. You doing dynamic meditation, reprogramming your mind, working on your goals, your health, whatever it may be. And then if any of you want to introduce someone to the silver method, or maybe you just want to have a bit of a review, I'm doing the four key skills or the four skills to empower you, which is an introduction to the silver method. It's a free webinar in August the 24th. So that's really for your family, friends, or people that you know who you think would benefit from doing the silver method. You know how it's helped you. It absolutely changed my life. That's why I'm compelled, as the words compelled, to teach it. And if you think it'll help someone else, share that with them, please. Even if they don't do the silver method 4-day course, they will get a lot of value out of that 1-hour webinar. I give away tips, techniques, and things to help them straight away. All right, guys, that's it from me. Thank you. Are there any questions? Open your lines, open your microphones, or put in the chat box. Anything. Did you enjoy it? Was it helpful? Did you like put your dream to the test? Did it spark any dream ideas for you? What, anything, any feedback? And then we'll go on to a quick meditation now. Okay. So just for the new people, thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks, Vandana. For the new people, just grab a pen and paper. Even though we're doing a meditation, you're going to write during the meditation at the very end. So have a piece of pen and paper and sit in the most comfortable position. So if it was like this, you would sit with it on your lap, so you don't have to really move much to write. You'll just peek your eye open and write some answers, and then you will close your eyes, go back to the meditation. So this is how, for the new people that will run, I'm going to put on some background music and just relax you fractionally from head to toe. We'll create an ideal place of relaxation and create a waterfall there and just imagine it flowing over us and cleansing our energy field and making us feel lovely and light and free. And then we're going to know that we've now worked on ourselves, just to, you know, we've just reset the body. We're now going to reset our intention for the month. And when we set the intention, this is when I'm going to ask you three questions. And when you're in meditation, after relaxing so deeply, the answers will come from your intuition. And I will also say the words that we're going to now, you know, tune into our higher self or our inner wisdom or our intuition. And I'll do a little 10-1 countdown. And then we're going to ask the questions. What I'd like to ask, please, is that you just write down your first impressions. Don't analyze anything. Don't double think or question yourself. The first impressions, just write them down. And if you can, all keep your cameras on. It's better that I can see if people are writing, so I don't move too quickly. As long as you're writing, I'll wait. And then I'll move on to the next question. There's just three questions, like, for your intention for the month. Okay. All right. Thank you, Laura. You have to go. Thank you so much. It's timely as I started working on it today. Fantastic. Very good. And then let me just see here. Ah, thank you, Serena. Thank you. Okay. All right. So I'll put on some music. Just relax. There's nothing for you to do right now. Just relax, follow the instructions, and enjoy. Just sit back and let this be something you just allow yourself to love and enjoy. I'll put my camera off. Please keep your cameras on. Hi, Caroline, just to say hi. I see you there. Thank you. And for those other people who joined, Shafiul, welcome. I see your name. Well, welcome, Fabian. Welcome, Ali. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Anyone else who joined? Kalashri, welcome to you too. Thank you for joining. Oh, I saw Anna there for a second. Hello, Anna. Lovely to see you. Okay. So find a comfortable position. Close your eyes. Take a nice deep belly breath in, and as you exhale, just allow the tensions in your body to release and float away. And as you take these deep, slow breaths in, just make sure you breathe into the lower belly, not into your upper chest, but fill your whole body when you breathe in, into your lower belly, as if you're squeezing the corners. And as you exhale, just relax. And you might even want to blow out, like you're blowing out a candle through your mouth. You can feel the tension just release. Now I just want to focus your attention on your scalp. Just relax your scalp. You might feel a tingling sensation. That's just an indication that you are relaxing and the blood flow is going back in that area as your blood vessels relax. Keep breathing deeply, slowly and rhythmically. And now relax your forehead. Focus on nothing else except relaxing your forehead. Relax your cheeks and your eyes. Relax your whole face. Now relax your tongue and your jaw. Relax your neck. And take a nice deep breath in now. And as you exhale, relax your shoulders, arms, and hands. Take another deep breath in, and as you exhale, relax your chest. And relax your back from your neck to the end of your spine. And take another deep belly breath in, and as you exhale, relax your abdomen. Relax your hip and pelvic area. Relax your thighs. Relax your knees. Relax your calves. Relax your feet all the way down to your toes. You are now experiencing a deep state of relaxation. Now you're going to create in your mind your ideal place of relaxation. It can be real or imagined, somewhere you've been or somewhere that you'd like to go, and allow it to be a place where you feel totally relaxed. Just begin to experience this place right now. Take your time. Now that you've created your ideal place of relaxation, you're going to add a waterfall of white light into the scene. Place it wherever you choose. The waterfall is gentle, allowing you to stand under the cascading white light. This light is a healing energy, a clearing energy. Your waterfall of light is now created. Walk over to the waterfall and stand under the white healing light. Allow the white light to swirl around you, encompassing you within its glow. This waterfall of white light is clearing all the stress, tension, and clutter away. Not just the stress, tension, clutter of the day, or the past week, or the month, or even the last year, but of your entire lifetime. Experience this waterfall of white light clearing the stress, tension, and clutter of your entire energy field, of your aura, your atmosphere. And as the light clears your energy, just notice how much happier you look. Notice the smile on your face. See how the weights that you've been carrying are no longer a burden. Notice how your energy field is expanding out as you are radiating love. This waterfall of light is available to you always, whenever you need it. All you need to do is close your eyes, imagine your ideal place of relaxation, and immerse yourself in this healing white light. Now I want you to take a deep breath, relax deeper, and repeat these beneficial statements to yourself mentally. Every day, in every way, I am getting better, better, and better. Repeat mentally after me. Positive thoughts, suggestions, and images bring me benefits and advantages I desire. I will always maintain a perfectly healthy body, mind, and immune system. The following statements are for your better health. Keep in mind, from now on, I will occasionally be speaking in your place. Every second, every minute, every hour, every day, every cell, tissue, organ, and system of my body is revitalized, restored, and renewed, resulting in a perfectly healthy body, mind, and immune system. I'm able to function in harmony physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually to promote maximum benefits. My awareness in using my mind allows me to do activities that promote increased health physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Now imagine the white light turns to green. You are now immersed in a glowing, beautiful green light. This green light is unconditional love. It surrounds you. It encompasses you. It flows through your entire being. It fills you with love. All those hurts you felt, all those pains you felt, the angry moments, allow this green light, this unconditional love, to heal all those spaces now. You are an amazing human being. You deserve love. You deserve joy. You deserve abundance and prosperity, and you deserve peace. It is now time to step out of the waterfall. Step out of the waterfall of light. Your energy field is now clean and clear. You are centered. You have clarity. You can focus easily. You are in the flow of universal love and energy. Just take a moment to bask in this feeling of connectedness. You have now reset your body and mind for the month ahead. It is now time to set your intention for the month of July. Tune in to your inner wisdom. Tune in to your intuition or your higher self, the part of you that when you tuned in guides you and intuitively knows what is best for you. I'm going to do a quick 10 to 1 countdown. When we reach the count of one, you will have tuned in to your own inner wisdom, your own guidance system, your intuition. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You are now tuned in to your inner wisdom, your higher self, the part of you that when you tuned in guides you and intuitively knows what is best for you. Feel the alignment with your higher self. And now ask yourself the following questions and write down your first impressions. Don't analyze anything, just write down your first impressions and then close your eyes and re-enter the meditation. The first question is, what do I need to focus on for the month of July? And then take a breath and close your eyes and just relax. I'm going to ask the second question. Just remember to write down whatever comes to mind. Just your first impressions. Don't question anything. The next question is, what steps do I need to take me closer to what I want to be, do, or have? Write down your first impressions. What steps do I need to take me closer to what I want to be, do, or have? And then the third question. Write down your first impressions once again. What do I need to let go of? What do I need to let go of? And then the last question is there anything else I need to know or anything else I need to do? Is there anything else? And now just allow a deep breath, and as you exhale, just relax. Slowly bring your attention back into your body. Be aware of the chair that you're sitting on or lying on or the couch or whatever it is. Just be aware of the room around you. Now, when I count from 1 to 5, at the count of 5, you'll open your eyes, be wide awake, feeling fine and in perfect health, feeling better than before. 1, 2, coming out slowly now. 3, at the count of 5, you will open your eyes, be wide awake, feeling fine and in perfect health, feeling better than before. 4, 5. Eyes open, wide awake, feeling fine and in perfect health, feeling better than before. Okay, welcome back, everybody. Did you enjoy that? Yes, you can unmute your microphones. Please feel free. I don't know how to do that for everybody, so you'll do your own.
Oh, thank you, Janine.
Thank you, Shafil.
Thanks, Janine.
Thank you, Anna.
Good night. Good night.
Hello.
Thank you.
Thanks, Janine. Love your work. That was fantastic. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you to you too. Thank you for joining. Thanks to everybody. I must thank you and commend you for taking the time to give yourself this hour and a half and look after yourself, learn something, add value to yourself, do a bit of a meditation. So well done. I commend you all. Excellent. Good for you.
Good night.
Thanks, good night, Janine. Everyone.
Good night. See you next time.
Best to you. Janine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Good night. That was